So by this method, there is the formation of species. But species formation is depend upon the genetic variation, as well as species formation depend upon the environmental condition. So the speciation is of various types. So the types of speciation. How the species are formed from a pre-existing population. So the first type of the speciation, that is the allopatric speciation. Allopatria, this is a Greek word and it means allos, that means other, and patria, that means the native land. Here I represent this diagram. See, there is the presence of the ancestral population. This ancestral population get bifurcated or divided into two groups, and both these groups are separated by the geographical barrier. There is the presence of various geographical barriers, like the ocean, like the mountains, like the forest, like the river, due to which the mating is not takes place in between these two populations, and these two populations are completely separated from each other. Such type of population is bifurcated by the geographical barriers. Okay, so these geographical barriers are mainly helpful in the allopatric speciation. So allopatric, that means the other type. Now this population is divided into two groups, and both these groups are separated by the geographical barrier. Suppose that there is the presence of great mountain, and due to the presence of that mountain, this population or these individuals cannot meet with each other, and they face the different environmental conditions. So from the ancestral species, from the ancestral population, there is the formation of a new species. There is the presence of the original species, and there is the formation of newly formed species. So such type of speciation is called as the allopatric speciation. Consider that the characters of the Indian persons and the character of the Australian or the African persons are much different from each other. Though we are members of Homo sapiens sapiens, but we represent somewhat different character. The person who live in the African countries, that person is somewhat darker, and the person who live here in India or Australia, they are somewhat fair in condition. Why this? Due to the presence of that environmental condition. I don't mean that these are the two different species of human being, because we are single species, but how the environmental factor affects on them. Okay, so that's what I call the allopatric speciation. The allopatric speciation, its best example is the Darwin finches, due to the geographical isolation. When the Darwin studies his theory, natural selection, on the Galapagos Island, he found that on the Galapagos Island there is a presence of the different type of finches, and these finches are differ from each other and also from the main island. Okay, so on each island there is a presence of the different type of finches. So he concluded that how the different type of finches are arises. So when one group of finches is migrated, or one type of birds are migrated on the another island, the environmental conditions which are present on that island, these environmental conditions acts on the morphological character or the genetic character of these organisms, and these organisms somewhat, or these finches somewhat, change their morphological character. Adaptive radiation, that means from the pre-existing population, when the groups are migrated in the different environmental conditions, their morphological characters get changed. This is the best example for the geographical isolation, because each island is separated from each other with the help of that ocean and with the help of that water. So the mating is not takes place in all these organisms, and the environmental condition create the difference in these finches. So this is the best example for the allopatric speciation, which is caused due to the geographical barrier. The second example is the Australian marsupials. All these marsupials, there is the presence of the kangaroo, there is the presence of marsupial rat, there is the presence of tiger cat, there is presence in the Tasmanian wolf, there is the presence of marsupial mole, there is the presence of koala, there is the presence of wombat. All these organisms are mainly derived from a single ancestral stock. But when they migrated to the different environmental condition, their characters can change. This is also one of the best example of the adaptive radiation. Okay, and this adaptive radiation So the geographical conditions are mainly responsible for the speciation. So such type of speciation is called as the allopatric speciation. So remember that. Allopatric speciation, that means on another land. Okay. It is caused due to geographical barriers. So geographical barrier is mainly responsible for isolation, and the speciation is called as allopatric speciation. And there are two examples. The first one is the Darwin finches, and the second one is the Australian marsupials. Okay. Now next, sympatric speciation. After the allopatric speciation, now we are going toward the sympatric speciation. Sympatria, this is also one of the Latin word. Sim means together, and patria, that is the native land. In the same native land or in the same area, if the population is divided into two groups, then there is the formation of new species. See here in this diagram. The first circle represents that is the ancestral species. Okay, or that is the geographical area. Now, in the second diagram, we can see that there is the formation of a new species, which is represented by the dotted line. And in the third circle, there is a green color new species, which is formed in the same native land together in the same space. There is the formation of the new species, that is called as the sympatric speciation. How the sympatric speciation is carried out? Sympatric speciation is carried out due to the reproductive isolation. Each and every organism having the different mode and the different type of reproduction. Okay, when the organisms are separated from each other on the basis of their habit, nature, and the techniques of reproduction, that is called as the reproductive isolation. And this reproductive isolation creates barrier in between the inbreeding of the population. When there is the formation of any barrier in the inbreeding population, that is called as reproductive isolation. Okay, and this reproductive isolation is given by the male. Male is one of the person who contribute his work in the modern synthetic theory, so that male gives this reproductive isolation. Mainly, the reproductive isolations are of two types. The first type of the reproductive isolation is pre-mating or pre-zygotic isolation. That means before mating, these organisms are reproductively separated from each other. And the second one is the post-mating or the post-zygotic isolation. After mating, these organisms are isolated from each other. So we will discuss each type of isolation here. Firstly, the pre-mating or the pre-zygotic isolation. In the pre-zygotic isolation, there is the presence of the different methods of isolating the organism in same native land. Okay. First one is the in-habitat isolation. This is the time of the pre-mating or the pre-zygotic isolation. Species occupy different habitat in the same locality. Suppose in a forest, there is the presence of a very high mountain, few organisms live at the bottom and few organisms live at the peak of the mountain. That means these organisms occupy different habitats. As they are present at the different habitat, so the mating in these organisms not takes place, so they are separated from each other by the reproductive isolation. Seasonal or the temporal isolation. Seasonal isolation. We know that every organism having its specific breeding season, and the breeding season of various animals are different from each other. Members of a population attain the sexual maturity at a different time, and they having the different breeding season, so they cannot meet with each other, so they are completely separated from each other. That is called as the pre-mating or the pre-zygotic isolation. Then the third one is the ecological or the behavioral isolation. Behavior. Every organism having different method or the different behavior for the sexual reproduction. Members of two population having the different mating behavior, and due to the difference in the behavior of mating, these organisms are separated from each other. Okay. Before reproduction. And the fourth factor or the fourth type is the mechanical. Mechanical, that means the member of two population having different in their structure or difference in their reproductive organs, in their structure, in their function, so they cannot meet with each other though they live in the same native land, but they are separated from each other with the help on the basis of reproduction. So that is called as pre-mating or the pre-zygotic isolation. Okay. Then the next method of the reproductive isolation, that is the post-mating or the post-zygotic isolation. Post-zygotic. Gamete motility. We know that the breeding season of a plant is also differ from each other. In the summer season, we got the mangoes. And in winter season, we got the different fruit. If, suppose that, the pollen grains of Goa, that means Peru, are dusted on the stigma of the mango. If fertilization is carried out or not? No. Fertilization is never carried out because they are gamete, get motility or the gamete get to die on the stigma of that mango. So the pollen grain, male and female gametes die before the fertilization. Though they are introduced into the different species, but they will definitely die. That is called as the gamete motility. Then secondly, zygote motility. Hybrid zygotes are not viable. Suppose we create such type of hybrids also, but the hybrid zygotes are not viable. They die before their development. Okay. So the zygote mortality, so post-mating, after the mating, there is also a problem. Then the hybrid sterility. The hybrids are sterile, they cannot reproduce. We create few hybrids here. Okay. Mule. Mule, that means the khechar, which is formed by the combination of horse and donkey. But these mules are sterile in nature. They are artificially created. They are not naturally created here. If in the nature one species mate with another species, then various hybrids will be formed. That means when the tiger meet with the lion, then there will be formation of the liger. And such type of different combinations, if takes place in this nature, then what will be its effect? So every species can reproduce with the member of its same species. So reproduction is a highly species specific activity, and on the basis of reproduction, all these organisms are separated from each other. That is called as the reproductive isolation. Okay. So this reproductive isolation is very important in that phenomenon of the sympatric isolation. So we discuss about the allo-